on the oil spill. So I wanted to ask you, because I read up on the Guimaras oil spill, actually what happened there. So the oil company then just actually spent 120 million pesos to those affected, which you look today would be quite small. But the nobody has really answered for the pollution damage. I believe then they were asking for the International Oil Pollution Compensation to handle it. Who answers for the marine damage, Justice Secretary? You've talked about it in your press conferences. What is the penalty for that?
Well, damage to the environment, there are penalties in the law, but not as harsh as we would want them to be.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, in this case, the compensation act that it's there for the insurance that gives a very, very big insurance payment. We are not a signatory to that. So we are looking at this from a point of view of a country that has to clean up its own mess afterwards. That's why we do not want to rely on the insurance angle being touted to us by many, even government agencies also, like the Marina and the Coast Guard, gung-ho on the insurance that will come out. We cannot tackle these people. That's why we have to police our ranks, we have to punish the guilty, and we have to clean up our own mess. In the end, Karen, we have to clean up our own mess.
I'm curious, will government as a whole file a case against the owners of MT Princess Empress?
That's what we are trying to establish now, Karen. We have subpoenaed to the NBI the documents necessary for us to determine a liability. The NBI is going to the ground, looking at the places where the vessels were supposed to be manufactured and established as seagoing vessels. We're going through the whole process, Karen. We just have to establish the facts properly. We have to establish liability, and definitely, Karen, where that ship sank and where the oil spill goes, that's what we call a scene of a crime. It's a crime against the environment, and it's a delict. It's even if it's an accident or it is intentional, it is a crime.
All right. Now, the International Criminal Court has just rejected the bid of the Philippine government to suspend the ongoing investigation of former President Duterte's drug war. What does this mean to us with the ICC rejecting the Philippines' appeal?
Well, we are talking to them as a country among nations that says we can handle our own problems. Mm. Well, I really don't know what they want to happen. If they want to take over our legal system, they want to take over our armed forces or our police forces, because they will have to come in with a compulsory process for us to be able to work out anything with them. Because right now, we're telling them, we can do it. Give us your complaint. We will do it. But if they insist on doing it, well, Karen, good luck to them, because they cannot enter our country to impose a rule of law different from ours. And our rule of law here is run by Filipinos.
But then, Secretary, I'm a bit confused, because are we sending a confusing message? The Philippines keep saying they have no jurisdiction, our courts are working, and yet why are we filing these appeals?
Well,
by appealing, it means we recognize them.
No, Arian, Karen, it's part of part of diplomacy. We have to exhaust all diplomatic means to get the message across. Before Solicitor General Guevara filed that, we spoke about it. We had a discussion about it before he proceeded to file the final pleading, with the understanding that it's really meant for diplomacy. For diplomatic purposes.
Okay. So that's the only purpose, right? Because
yes.
When you file something, when you ask for something, it means you are recognizing that body's jurisdiction over you.
Not necessarily, Karen. We're not anymore members of the ICC. So that is a very big question, Karen. Even if they say they still have jurisdiction given the time frame that expired. Well, Karen, how will they compel us to act in any manner?
Okay. On that note, is there anything you'd like to add, Justice Remulla, before we go?
Wala na. The ICC is the ICC, and good luck to them also if they want to arrest Putin. I want to see them do that because they're big on words, but let them do it first. So we will believe that they can really do what they say.
On that note, Justice Secretary Crispin Remulla, thank you for joining me today. Have a good day, sir. I'll see you again.
Okay, bye.